Two high-profile cases involving children are getting a lot of social media attention tonight by IMPD. Good evening, everyone. I'm John Stair.
And I'm Anne-Marie Tiernan. It's now 6 o'clock. Investigators say with so many people following police on Facebook and Twitter, it could be one way to find a teenager's killer and a baby's kidnapper. Our Crime Beat reporter Steve Jefferson tonight has a look at this social media push to solve area crime.
Anne-Marie and John, right now, police say social media is very important to their investigations, especially with what happened here. Dominique Allen's body was found near that memorial you see behind me. They say since people are on social media, on their smartphones basically all day, they hope to reach out to them for important cases like this one.
As many people as possible.
Naira Watts hopes a recent tweet from Metro Police can help find who killed family friend Dominique Allen. Detectives have already checked hundreds of online clues after finding her body behind a North Elder Avenue vacant house partially burned.
She was a pretty, beautiful young lady with her whole life ahead of her, and we really want justice. We want to know why, we want to know who.
Police are also looking for the who and why in the case of missing six-week-old Delano Wilson. Gone almost 2 weeks now. His father told officers a man and woman kidnapped his newborn during a robbery near their Southwest Side home. Thousands of people follow IMPD on Facebook and Twitter. The hope is one of those followers can help.
People are on their phones a lot during the day and on social media quite a bit, so we have an opportunity to reach a large audience to get our message to them too about those cases.
I'm not for sure, but
in addition to social media, Dominique's friends are doing it the old-fashioned way, passing out thousands of flyers.
This flyer has "Who murdered Dominique Quinet Allen?"
Hoping somebody somewhere can help bring them some closure.
Yeah, police aren't including the hotline for Crime Stoppers, 262-TIPS, in their social media messages to let people know they can call and remain anonymous and hopefully help them in high-profile cases. Reporting live, Steve Jefferson, Channel 13, Eyewitness News.
Let's hope it does some good. Thank you, Steve.